Hi. So it is Friday night, cooking up a like yummy dinner. But basically it is a broccoli, broad bean and butternut squash curry. And I'm really excited, and I'm gonna have it with some of this organic edamame spaghetti. It's really high in protein.
Pasta, and in 100 grams,
wait, I didn't even know they did that.
Yeah, and in 100 grams, you get 45 grams of protein, and in 50 grams, you get 22 grams of protein.
Oh my God, where'd you get it from?
Realfoods.co.uk.
How much is it?
Only like £3.
What?
If you order £30 or more, they do free delivery.
And it tastes like pasta. Noodles, pasta. So I'm going to put it like with my curry, like a Thai kind of curry. And I've just made dessert, which is this pumpkin pudding. I'm really excited about this. This was tofu, pumpkin puree, cinnamon, some maple syrup, and some dates I've just added to it, and some like almond flavour, and I'm just going to put it in the fridge, maybe freezer, and it like kind of will thicken up into like a pudding, and that I think that's fit into my macros. So yeah, you said prawns would be fine. He's gonna eat fish this time. Guys, I literally don't think I can actually eat all this. And look, that's 50 grams of protein, of the edamame spaghetti, which is 22 grams of protein.
That's quite a lot.
And then like, look, that's my boyfriend's bowl. And then that's meant to be like all of mine, all in my macros. I'm actually like, think I've done something wrong. I'm gonna go over them, but and puddings in my macros. Life is good right now. I'm well excited. Something's gotta be wrong. I had a trainer say to me when I got into this fitness stuff about a couple years ago, and she was like, "Danny, you need to eat more." And I was like, "No, don't even trick me, because if I eat more, I'm blatantly gonna get fat, so don't even try it. Why are you trying to make me fat? Like, literally, why is she trying to make me fat?" It took me about another year to even like believe that it wouldn't make me fat. But like, and it's true, like if I'm used to, so I used to go from 1200 calories for like 3 months, where I'd be trying to go around that number, then I'd go on holiday and I'd be skinny for like 2 weeks, and I'd eat like 4000 calories a day, then come back and I'd be blobby and wobbly, and then I would carry on eating crap for like 2 months, 3 months, because I'd be like, well, F it, I'm already blobby, so I might as well just carry on eating crap. And then I would go on another diet when, like, I think Christmas was coming, or another holiday was coming, and I'd go back to this 1200 calorie diet. So it was always like starvation, binge, starvation, binge. Firstly, I feel like I had to really reset my body, because like there was no, I couldn't understand why I wasn't losing weight at 1200 calories, but my body was so used to 1200 calories that was what it lived off of, that was what it maintained at. My body was just used to this whole 1200 calorie thing, because that was the majority of the time. Then I'd have a moment of binge where I'd put on a bit of weight and then I'd come down, but like because it was so used to that, there was no leeway. There was, what was I gonna have to do, eat 900 calories? If this is what I maintain at, then there's only, you can, at the end of the day, losing fat is, you have to create a deficit. You have to. Yes, you can eat really well, but I was eating crap. This was anything over 1200 was a surplus, straight off, because like my body was maintained at 1200, and it wouldn't lose unless I went lower than that. So I was like literally trapped in, sorry, I'm gonna stir these beans, in that place. And I've, you know, I get it, I know it, I know the feeling of not wanting to eat more calories. It's fucking scary if you've got body image issues and you do fear that you're gonna get big. And I really, really hate that there's such an emphasis on getting bigger like, why is it such a big deal? Like, who told us that being bigger wasn't acceptable or not, wasn't even beautiful? Like, because even that brings its own connotations. Like, why is it just not acceptable? That's what I can't fathom. And I know to some people it is, and I know to some, a lot of my friends, body image isn't, you know, there was always a massive difference. Like, people that would moan about, oh, I've got a bit fat, but oh, I feel fat in these jeans. And that's where I would say I was at. But really what was going on inside me was I'd be sitting there literally at dinner, like, freaking out and feeling sad that I just felt large. And I hate even saying those words, because what the F? Because I didn't look at big people bigger than me ever and think, oh my God, they must be so sad because they're large. Ever. Like, it was never about anybody else. Because I knew through other people's eyes, I looked normal. Whatever that means. In my head, it wasn't even about what size I was. I'm not that much different to what I was in March when I started, like, my transformation. But I feel like a 10 times thing. It was always about being comfortable in my own skin. I sort of actually need to, like, cook whilst I'm talking to you, don't I? Okay. So here we've got some roast veg and butternut squash. Probably going to use most of that for dinner later, but I thought while I'm cooking, I might as well just cook it now. Anyway, we've got some roast veg and butternut squash, which will be part of mostly, like, lunch tomorrow, but I will obviously use a little bit for breakfast now. I've got egg tofu scramble with onion and chives and herbs. Then my boyfriend's got beans with smoked paprika, tandoori masala and garam masala. So I made some little poo drops of joy. That right there is heaven on earth. I'm so excited. I will explain how to make them once I've enjoyed them. Bye. Keeping it real. Dairy free ice cream in a Yorkshire pudding as a snack. Not in my macro. You know I don't wanna know. As I said, I didn't prepare any food, or I have some quinoa and vegetables, but I'm gonna have that later for more of a dinnery snack because I'm in work till 9. I'm going into Marks and Spencer's and I'm gonna talk you through what I'm gonna get. I'm gonna get this, no gluten, and I'm gonna get a edamame and hummus protein. protein pot. Let's go crazy. Oh, I'm gonna get some mango. I've not had mango for ages. All right, so I'm starving. Anyway, let's see, I'll add it all up and we'll see. Okay, bye. So I said to my boyfriend, can you please add eggs to the bowl? We're making a mushroom and rose pepper butternut squash omelette with some chive and some sweet potato fries. Oh, what a dick. This is my outfit for the evening. Looking good, guys. I'm a giraffe, by the way, just in case you weren't sure. And the best bit about this